fact that they've got the Nunu pick up their sleeve that just got banned away, by the way, as we do jump into Champion Select. So Detonation Focus Me, I like that first one. Means that you can really get Yadapon built up and into the back line. And wow, there's a lot of bans focused at that bottom lane right now. Kalista also taken away. Nautilus for Detonation Focus Me.
In fact, every single ban seems to be revolving around that bottom lane here as well. Nautilus and Morgana, of course, wouldn't normally, I guess, well, Morgana most definitely has been.
Oh, well, actually, that's true.
But theoretically, bottom lane ban.
Not theoretical at all. That is a ban at Smurf.
Yeah.
In the top lane there, of course. He is a Morgana player coming through for a hard random.
My little point really DeMonco, did not go through there at all.
More of the Janna Lulu coming through. No Morgana for him.
And Astaroth not going to be seeing his Gragas here at the same time as hard random are going to ban that one away. Sejuani in response. And Symphony has been the one prioritizing that. Astaroth not really worried about the Sejuani pick too much. Does still love the Jarvan, but Smurf just going to lock away that Rek'Sai straight away for Symphony.
Yeah, and Rek'Sai being picked up. We mentioned that this isn't a shared jungle pool, so prioritizing Rek'Sai, that blows my mind because Astaroth doesn't really go for something like that. As we said, more interested in the Nunu. I think that now that's been taken away, he'll go something like an Udyr or at least Sin on the current patch.
Do you think Jarvan still fits in the meta?
Nah, not at all.
Wow, okay. Not really even a little bit.
No, really don't think Jarvan's a good pick anymore. He lost a lot of his team-based focus. His ultimate doesn't really add much with Kalista running around on the map because she just jumps out of it. Even though it's banned away at the moment, you got things that just have too many gap closes, and I just don't think that the Wombo is there. I like the fact that they've gone for a Thresh though, because that doesn't give anything away. You can run Pick, you can run Peel, it's engaged at certain points. So the fact that they've coupled that up with probably the best Peel tank in the top laner in Maokai is good. However, what it has meant for hard random is that Hecarim is still available. And Hecarim Kalista, Hecarim Rek'Sai, real scary.
Hecarim, Rek'Sai, and potentially a Lulu coming through here as hard random are hovering that one. We don't know whether that's necessarily going into the top, mid, or support here at this stage. But we will see DeMonco actually known to play that Lulu.
Yeah, exactly. So expect that to go into the bottom lane. I like the fact that they've got the Lulu once again away from Detonation Focus Me, because even though Seros isn't known to play it, Lulu, as well as a good AD carry on the current patch, is real scary.
Yeah.
So being able to get that away from the middle laner from Detonation Focus Me means that they won't be able to get the AD carry position going as quickly. So far, we've got kind of two team comps that haven't given much away. Solo lanes haven't been picked up for hard random as of yet, as Jarvan is locked in.
Yeah.
And you called it. We know that Astaroth plays it, but I don't know whether it has a place on the current patch.
Well, we'll see whether it works out as we move into this one. It is looking like
you're going to be a real happy
Ezreal's
man
being
if
considered.
That Ezreal is locked in. Because Yadapon plays a very interesting Ezreal build.
Oh, I just cannot wait.
Yeah, it has an Essence Reaver in there. For those playing at home,
we could have let it be a surprise.
No surprises coming through here. So Essence
Reaver. He's got an ability called Essence Flux as well. Why hadn't anyone else decided to build that item?
Because it's not a fantastic item coming through there, Alice. Although it
does. Reduction,
yeah, it's got everything Ezreal needs on a piece of paper. But then you look at the other BF items that give you a heck of a lot more, and it loses some of its attractiveness.
I don't know what you're talking about. Lex considering a Hecarim here. The top lane is DeMonco hovering the Diana here, and we were talking about Kira's Diana earlier on. Does like to play those assassins there in the mid lane, but blind picking a Diana into Seros, is that smart?
Yeah, it's kind of strange coming through because Diana, she is a little bit risky being melee, but then again, she doesn't really have that many hard counters outside of maybe something like an Orianna that I actually haven't seen Seros play. So I don't mind the blind pick into it too much. We'll have to be careful with some of the lane matchups. However, that Hecarim is going to be really scary again. We mentioned how good Hecarim is at zoning out an AD carry solo. We saw it firsthand in the last game. The fact that it was able to go through third rounds of picks is mind-boggling for me.
Yeah, it's completely ridiculous. And actually, having a look over at the hard random lineup here, you've got Diana diving in with her big shield, which actually stacks up a little bit faster. Now, you've also got that wild growth on top of it, and the fact that you're not going to be kited as heavily because you have the On the Hunt. there's a lot of augmentation for this Diana to really get work done.
Yeah, there certainly is. So I like what you mentioned there, because realistically, Sivir is a hit R and go bot again in this team comp. There are three huge divers and a Lulu on the lineup, which is going to mean nothing but good things for Hard Random. Like the comp they've put together, Diana surprisingly tanky in that mid lane as well, so fits the MO that we're going for here. On the other side of the rift, Syros has picked up Azir, and we were speaking about control mages really countering out Diana. In lane, going to be a good matchup coming through for Azir. However, out of lane, they're not really going to bump heads, because Diana, she wants to go to a split push scene, try and assassinate people from the flanks. Azir is all about that team fighting and setting up siege potential for his team.
Yeah.
You put a turret behind you, you put your wall in front of you, all of a sudden you got 15 sand soldiers, people are going crazy everywhere, and you take turrets ridiculously quickly. So they're going for two kind of different team comps here, and I want to see how it works out head to head. We mentioned the fact that CIS coming into this, much more team orientated. They've set up kind of a 1-3-1 split push comp here.
Yeah.
On the other side of the map, you can see where the protect the AD carry focus is coming through. You've got some Peel and Thresh, you've got a Jarvan, you've got Maokai for his ultimate coming through, you've got Azir to push everyone away. A lot of pressure now on Syros and Yutapon to carry this game.
Yeah, and a lot of area control coming through here from Focus Me as well. They've got Ezreal who's super safe, and then everyone who can really ruin these fights.
Yeah, there certainly is. So people that can shove you around, create walls. We've seen Azirs do crazy things with their ultimate, people getting bounced in and out of that thing. But the other thing I want to touch on quickly is in the top lane, Smurf didn't take Smite.
No, he's still got the Ignite.
He took Ignite, which is a little bit different. Means he doesn't have the clean item build. The reason I like Smite so much on Hecarim is it cleans his item build up a lot. No longer do you have to choose, am I going aggressive or defensive? Because you get a reasonably good laning item because of the aura that comes out of Cinderhulk. Yeah. You get some nice scaling for late game, but it's actually a ridiculously good duelist item. So it gives you kind of the offensive flair without having to commit to a Trinity Force, which is just so expensive. So he's gone instead for a little bit more laning power with the Ignite. Before you pick up the Skirmishing Saber, of course, Ignite's just so good. Yeah. Maybe that means they like to dive top lane and they're going to concentrate on getting bonds in behind, but it's just a little bit different on this patch.
Yeah, it is. And they're going in with a double teleport here at the same time. So Diana picking that one up in the mid lane as well. We are going to hop onto the Rift, ladies and gentlemen, but we'll see whether Hard Random are going to go for any exciting shenanigans early on with this double teleport as we are onto the Rift. Hard Random on the blue side. And of course, Detonation Focus Me on the red heading down this one. And we're not going to have any level one face checks this time around, I do not think.
No, we're definitely not. We're just going to have everyone spreading out. Kira actually taking Q first. That's kind of, I guess, yeah. I don't know about taking Q against an Azir. The reason for it is because he does a heck of a lot of harass level one. Generally, it's good to be able to walk up to the minion wave with your W on, get the three auto attacks off, use your passive to push it out, and then make the wave shove into him. So you get level two first.
Yep.
And then you can take the Q and start trying to harass. Instead, what that means is probably going to be zoned from level one is Kira if Syros plays this lane well. So we'll have to see exactly how that one works out. Take a look at Kazu in the bottom lane. He's just hanging out as Thresh, chilling. Real tanky at the moment.
Yeah, definitely tanky. Actually, I looked at his health bar and thought, okay, that could potentially be a Doran shield. Look down, not a Doran shield, still just a relic. So looks to me like Detonation Focus Me thinking about taking away the little sentinels here from the blue buff, trying to get to an early level two.
Yeah, so that's what they'll do. They'll take away at least one blue sentinel there and be able to get some of their work done. As we see Syros as well as Bonzen, they prepped the Wraith camp there. They're able get all of the CS across onto the mid laner, I believe.
Probably not all of them. The big Raptor may not be taken down. Is actually Lex and DeMonco going to be taking down the Krugs? We'll see whether they just take a little one. No, they're going for both. So heading to lane a little bit less healthy, but definitely going to be able to grab that level two early, considering the fact that they are going to be sharing that experience, not giving instant level two over to either one of them. As Smurf almost actually dying to those Raptors, but is going to be able to head back to base, maybe grab a few more potions and then teleport up to that lane as Bonzen's shoving that one in. Of course, Detonation Focus Me are going to know exactly what happened here from Hard Random, seeing the fact that they lost a whole bunch of their health. But as far as laning phase goes, we are going to have 2v2s and 1v1s. And how does Sivir Lulu do against Thresh Ezreal?
Yeah, so Sivalulu is a little bit of a weird lane. They shove up out really well level one because they have the Glitter Lance as well as the auto attack reset coming through from Siva's W. However, not going to lane straight away means that they lose some of that advantage. And Ezreal can also just sit there and Q minions. And he pushes the wave relatively well as well. So we'll have to see how it works out. However, Ezreal versus Sivir's always been a really good matchup for Sivir. Because you tank the first Q, you get some of your mana back. And then all of a sudden, you just unload with a really good burst combo coming through. As you saw, level one, Kiro got absolutely smashed by Xeros. It was because he took the Q, once again, mentioned that pregame, got punished for it. He's lost both of his potions. He's down 7 CS and is completely zoned.
Yeah, and what do you think about the fact that he hasn't taken a flask here as well as Manasir watching the international? Oh my goodness. Are they your hands? That's gloves on his feet. Oh my goodness. He's trolling me. As Astro actually heading towards that bottom side. Demonko getting ignited up here as well as Detonation Focus Me losing a bunch of health in this bottom side. Lex staying healthy, but there's Symphony flashing forward with the knockup, but he might actually die for it as Unipon goes so aggressive. First blood for Astro as he goes down very low. Demonko picks up the double buffs, but Unipon, he's got him now as Lex. He's trying to fight back. Kazoo, my goodness, is he low. But Ezreal locks down the double buffs, hits level 3, 1-0-1, and man, for a team that plays around their AD carry, it's a pretty good start.
Yeah, it certainly is. Kazoo came up huge in that trade, actually took a lot of the brunt of the damage as Kira going down very low in the mid lane, able to equalize CS, but needs to go back and get a quick shop. And as you mentioned, Detonation Focus Me, they love playing around Unipon in the bottom lane. Kazoo is that support that they like to use for Peel. All of a sudden, double buff Ezreal going to have no problem with this lane. Picks up an early kill, picks up the early advantage in CS, and all of a sudden, Ez looking real pretty.
He's looking real strong there on the bottom side of the map. Bonzen actually falling behind Smurf as well, which is a little bit frightening considering Hecarim's scaling potential. Astro actually thinking of going aggressive under Kira here. He uses that Pale Cascade in order to trade a little bit more effectively, but Symphony coming round here now. It is going to be 2v2 here, but nice knock-up. Going to stop that one, but Symphony, he's paying for it. Xeros is going to take him down. He's very, very low. Flashes over the top as Kira's going to flash to follow. Picks up the kill as Demonko comes round as well. Nice whimsy for a shield, but Flag and Drag is going to get Astro out of trouble. Smurf was even coming down. Man, there are parties in these lanes.
Yeah, so Smurf was able to push out and then roam down. He's got a lot of potions, so he's just been recklessly shoving into Bonzen in the top lane. The roam coming through from Demonko probably sealed the early aggressive coming through there. So once again, a one-for-one trade. This time, mid laner fell, however. So you would say in the favor of the CIS team, Hard Random getting the better of that one. But the action early game, what an explosive game as a hook just misses wide there. They're not really looking to trade with this Ezreal anymore. Kazoo trying to zone them.
Unipon just preying upon this bottom lane. And he's not going to get punished for the early tier pickup as well. Has picked up an extra Doran's Blade at the same time. So going for early power plus a tier. A little bit strange.
Yeah, it certainly is a little bit strange coming through there. But the early tier means it's going to be stacking very quickly. Not to mention the fact that he gets some sustain through Doran's Blade, so maybe just looking to cover up for a power spike. Dorans are actually the most cost-effective items to build in the game. They're just not slot-effective because they don't turn into anything. As we see Symphony sneaking in on Bonzen.
Yeah, there's the ultimate to come through here from Smurf as well, who gets ignited up. Chilling Smite to come down. Cute little twisted advance into the flash is going to mean that Bonzen is going to survive.
Yeah, but he uses a flash, and that's going to be a return gank coming through whenever you want. As Kira, he's now hit level 6, and you see the zone potential already coming through from the Diana player. The one thing that we didn't mention to do with the double teleport whilst we mentioned it is the fact that Xeros has an exhaust, which means that if he gets it through before the first ultimate hits,
yeah,
he negates a heck of a lot of damage coming through a burst assassin like Kira. So I like the pickup there. It means a 2v2 skirmish all of a sudden coming through from the Jarvan Azir. Really effective against something like the Diana Rek'Sai.
Yeah, and Symphony so far has been super aggressive this game. Of course, went for that gank in the top lane, but has been almost suiciding into the lanes before that. Asteroid does notice the fact that that blue buff has gone down yet again. Of course, on the clock here for Symphony as he's able to head around that map very, very quickly. Of course, doesn't quite have Void Rush just yet, but he's going to have it soon. Ooh, Symphony almost there in smite range. Does try to pray seek it out, but doesn't get there. As DetonatioN focused me with a slight advantage early on to almost the tune of 1,000 gold, but nothing too much to write home about. But Smurf, he's actually behind in levels based on, although Bonzen actually had to go back.
Yeah, he had the biggest creep wave there, so he was able to equal that one out. He's picked up the cannon creep as well at the end. Bonzen had already killed his cannon creep. Cannon creep's OP, give you lots of experience and gold. Never miss those one, guys. As now the blue buff's picked up for Kira in the top lane, in the mid lane, so he's going to be able to go back, spam out some more Qs, kill some more minions, and this is what we're expecting out of these two teams. Some early aggression, but really strong laning phases coming through. I don't expect the laning phase to end anytime soon.
Wow, that Crescent Strike just missing onto Seros there. He's going to go back yet again, though, because Kira just feels like, I'm not entirely sure, actually just faking that one out. He's going to head back into this mid lane, clear out that last wave, actually going to equalize the CS as Seros is going to head over and pick up the blue buff, handed over there by Astro. Quite timely, DeMonco and Lex finding their way back into this lane. Yutapon still with a slight advantage, but of course, not exactly pressuring that lead that he could have possibly gained a little bit more out of based on the double buffs.
But the thing about Ezreal lanes is that they just shouldn't win in the AD carry position. So if you're up in CS, you're doing a really good job. And he hits a nicer spike coming through there with the Muramana than what Lex will. So the ability to be able to shove around the Sivir early is definitely in Yutapon's advantage. So whilst he's not killing his lane opponent, the fact that he's anywhere remotely in control of the lane, he's forced Sivir into double Doran's longsword as well. So you can probably expect another Brutalizer to come out. Seems to be flavor of the month, and I missed the memo somewhere. But yeah, it's definitely in the advantage of the DetonatioN Focus Me bottom lane.
Yeah, we've seen a decent amount of sort of Infinity Edge and Ghostblade Sivirs to come through as well. So we'll see whether that is going to be a thing. A Symphony looking for another gank here in the mid lane. Not going to find any joy, though, as Seros able to play back quite fast. Now with a 16 CS lead, Fiendish Codex sitting on and double Doran's Ring. So wanting to really put the pressure down early on here. Another Crescent Strike not quite going to find the mark as Kira hanging out there. Astro is going to look for the top side of the map and not find anything either. So a lot of explosive action very early on in this game, but it's slowed down just slightly now. We'll see whether there's going to be any sort of dragon action as there's a teleport in the mid lane, and I spoke too soon. Beautiful Emperor's Divide. May not quite get Seros to safety as Ignite sticking down. Last Stick doesn't find it. Beautifully played by Seros in the mid.
Yeah, so he's able to get away, uses all of his summoner spells, but that might mean the first objective goes down. All of a sudden, hard random, they have to take a look at Dragon. It's about that 10-minute mark. They've forced the mid laner back. Actually, they don't go for it. So instead, just continuing the laning phase out here. They're not able to pick up a kill, so they're just going to continue to roam around the map, see if Symphony can get anything done in the bottom lane.
Yeah, not quite able to capitalize too much on that as another ult comes through here from Smurf, looking for the 1v1 as Bonzen does put down the Ventral Maelstrom, but he's getting rampaged on. Smurf running out of mana here just a little bit, but Bonzen, again, just going to be fine there on the top side.
Yeah, and I think that the Maokai at this point a little bit too hard to 1v1 out, so that's a confusing use of the ultimate. Didn't use it in the initial gank. In the end, doesn't get anything in the top lane either. Bonzen, he's got the Catalyst of the Protector already. He's got his passive. Just going to be able to heal up on the next creep wave. He'll be completely fine. Even has the teleport advantage. So not much going to happen in the top lane. That was a little bit hopeful. Blindly optimistic, probably the word I would use. Or a couple of words. In that, and really a huge lull around the map. We've seen spurts of aggression, as you mentioned. Now we're seeing some pushing coming through, but everyone looks like they just want to...
Oh, Symphony looking for it as well. Seros, really the focus here is there's the Moonfall, the knock-up from the Umbaro as well, and lock down the kill, of course. Emperor's Divide almost off cooldown, but not quite there.
That was a huge commit coming through there onto the mid lane, and they're able to pull it off for the fact that he used all of his summoner spells last time to get away. They knew the ultimate wasn't available, only just came back off cooldown, so they're able to go for the repeat gank, expend a lot to get there, but in the end, definitely worthwhile because they're going to pick up the first dragon.
Yeah, grabbing the first dragon, of course, hard random, only behind by about six. Oh my goodness!
Not even
almost
close.
The True Shot Barrage steal. It was down below a quarter health, Spawn. It was an exciting moment. Don't take this away.
As we see, just even more farming coming through in the mid lane, and Yutapon, he went for it. He wasn't able to nail it. A little bit of dueling potential now gone from the bottom lane. And we're starting to see Lex and DeMonco push out this lane. This is what Sivir likes to do. She finally went for the BF sword, able to get that one. So it was delayed a little bit, but now they're in firm control, at least wave control-wise. Because no ultimate coming through from Ezreal means that there is zero pushback.
Yeah, and I guess Lex probably on the first back there, of course, after that trade went sort of horribly wrong, wanted to make sure that they had as many combat stats as they possibly could. You can use that longsword later, of course, for a whole lot of different things. So having it sit around there in your inventory, not too much of a big deal. So I actually quite like it now thinking back.
Yeah, so the thing about AD carry at the moment, as there's another game.
Oh my goodness, beautiful death sentence into the delivery system as DeMonco is going to fall down, flag and drag onto Lex, but On the Hunt is going to allow him to stay safe, but man, Detonation focused me with a beautifully orchestrated gank.
Yeah, so Astaroth able to get in there, uses the ultimate after the flash to make sure it locks down the support player in DeMonco. He falls off the rift, and once again, another kill over to Utapon, so they're starting to get their AD carry fed and really going. He's working on the Mura Mana transformation as we speak, so yeah, and really can't fault what the Detonation Focus Me jungler just was able to do.
Yeah, and Lex a little bit slow on the fingers there with the spell shield as Utapon trying to get some extra damage down. Actually goes for an aggressive arcane shift. Interestingly done, but not going to net him anything.
Blue buff being handed over to the mid laner. I wonder if they go in on Syros again. They know that his flash isn't up for about another, I'm going to say about 30 seconds now. So if they can get another gank in after they pick up red buff, they might be able to take him down one more time. Although exhaust is available as well as ultimate. And you feel Diana will deal handedly with Ezreal late game. So currently, probably advantage hard random. Even though the gold says advantage Detonation Focus Me. And I want to see how this one works out.
Yeah, Utapon actually looking for a mystic shot over the wall there as DeMonco heads back into this lane.
Actually gives away the position of the ward there, so not worth it. They were actually setting up for a Rek'Sai gank. Symphony was in there, so the fact that he was willing to Q pass the wall means that he's not wasting any of the Rek'Sai's time. So a little bit of a tiny things, but things like that mean that maybe Symphony sticks around for an extra 10 seconds looking for that gank. And then they can make a play elsewhere.
Speaking of which, actually now looking for Utapon now. Beautiful fake out on the maneuver, but man, that boomerang almost finishing him off. Another moonfall to come through here as the Emperor's Divide only gets rid of the Diana. Seros, man, that was lovely use of the E. Survives another one.
Yeah, but has to use flash on cooldown again, Atlas. And all of a sudden, if Astaroth wasn't there, that would have been a kill because the flash was still available, ultimate was still available coming through from Kira. Would have been able to get in there and affect another gank, and they're starting to pick on Syros. He's staying extremely even in CS, so props to him for really being able to stick in this lane even though he's starting to get focused pretty heavily. But not much coming through from Kira so far.
Yeah, hard random actually reading the MO there is. That is going to be the Crescent Strike not going to land. Of course, Detonation Focus Me. I mean, they're going to focus someone, at least, although it doesn't necessarily work for everyone.
No, so in the end, they're going to be able to make that one work out. And in the top lane, Smurfy's still doing reasonably well, farming up extremely well, actually, on Hecarim. Maokai wins that lane quite handily as they're going aggressive in the bottom lane. Wow!
Yeah, box used, but Lex not going to take any damage from it. Just wanders out of the way casually.
Yeah, so in the end, not really much advantage there. Wow.
Oh, yeah, teleport to come through from Smurf here. He's looking for something. Now feels like he's in the wrong place. Is Bonzen going to teleport in as well? And again, another stalemate, but another teleport. Let's get as many teleports down here as we possibly can. As there's the Crescent, but beautiful use of a flash onto the Dark Passage. Not quite enough as Kira's going to get speed boosted. They do manage to get one pick. Dragon not up for another minute and a half. But hard random, they use so many summoner spells.
Yeah, they certainly did, and we were kind of warned about this. Nothing up to fight over, but for some reason, they just pick to start up the little bit of a brawl. Smurf, as well as Kira, able to get into that bottom lane, so they win out in the end.
Kazu's
now they're chasing over the whole map to try and catch Kazu, who has Moby Boots. So yeah, he's not in much trouble, able to just wander away.
Yeah, a little bit of cute stuff coming through there for these guys as Lex down the bottom side of the map is going to use all of his mana to farm this one out. Utapon now is easily going to continue stacking up this mana immune. As just checking it out. Nice little smile there coming through. Lots of people with
glorious
so
beard.
Many monitors, man. It's beautiful. Beautiful to see this many monitors.
I couldn't see past the beard. I'm sorry. I don't know what you're talking about.
Oh, I think there was a monitor there.
And I just have to ignore the beards because I just can't grow one to save my life.
As we see, actually, a Rod of Ages Maokai coming through in the top lane for Bonzen. So committing a little bit further into the late game build, we sort of saw that fall away in popularity as Righteous Glory became the standard pickup. But with laning phases going for as long as it is in this game, can't really blame Bonzen. He's going to have that stacked up and going to be more of a late game damage threat than we expected out of the top lane.
Yeah, already has that Glacial Shroud completed as well. So obviously going towards that Frozen Heart as his next option. Symphony looking for something else here in the mid lane as he is spotted by a ward. Pale Cascade going to give Kira a bit of a shield for not really too much gain. Symphony now going to start up the dragon straight away and hard random. Looking to try and make this two for nothing.
Yeah, but in the top lane, Detonation Focus Me, they've gone towards the turret, so they're looking to just push another lane, give away the dragon, try and go for another snipe, but once again, not really that successful. So, Yudapon, he's 0 for 2.
Yep, and I didn't get quite as excited for that one, of course. Not quite through to the quarter mark, as Kira now going to put a whole lot of pressure here on the turret. That passive just doing so much work.
Yeah, Syros, he was looking to be dove again. The pressure in the mid lane has just been out of control coming out of hard random. And they've picked up the second dragon. They're 800 gold behind, but that's about the turret worth in the top lane. Is now Kazu looking for an engage.
Yeah, Descent's. Oh, wow. That was actually onto Smurf there. A bit of a fake out play to come through from Kazu. Doesn't pay off.
Faked out everyone, kind of threw the field gold in between
Maybe
both
himself.
Of them.
Maybe himself more than anyone else. Symphony now looking for something over the wall here. Prayseeker not going to find the blue buff as Yudapon had started that one up but decides to give up on it. Now heading towards this bottom side and is just going to farm out this wave, maybe push up towards that turret. Kira now with a sneaky lead. Of course, with so much focus from hard random there in the mid lane, you would expect this, but now has a needlessly large rod as well as those boots too and the Abyssal Scepter.
Yeah, I like that you call it sneaky because that was kind of like a smack you in the face lead. They just sat every resource on the map in mid lane and let him accrue a CS advantage. So I'm not sure if I call that stealth, kind of the Shen approach to being a ninja coming through there from hard random, but they definitely did get their mid laner in a real good position.
Yeah, they got their 13 CS in the lead, 3-0-0, definitely looking very good. But we were mentioning before, and it was difficult in the beginning of the laning phase for this Diana.
Oh, it was so difficult. Gave up advantage level 1 by taking the Q and just walking into lane with the Dorian's Ring, not going for a flask or anything to give any kind of advantage over to the Diana player. We said the control mages would be fine early game. Now that the
Oh my goodness, Kira actually taken down there by Syros. 1v1, Emperor's Divide doing a whole lot of work. And Azir, we know that he scales beautifully into the late game, and Syros is definitely demonstrating it.
Yeah, well, we were doing an exercise before
the cast,
as Syros, now being a little bit dove from Smurf, decides against it, of what gets through Emperor's Divide.
Yeah.
And the thing is that Diana doesn't. She headbutts it. So once you get the first one, if you can't 100% the Azir on the first full combination, you can't re-dive through with the ultimate, which puts you in a very awkward situation because if you don't have flash available, which Kira didn't, you have to walk around the wall or get out. And it's very hard to move away from an Azir as well with the slows coming through, with the fact that you get bounced around a little bit. So in the end, lost the straight up 1v1 because 100-to-1 potential wasn't there. Now gone for the distortion enchant, not only for the teleport, but for more chances to flash through that wall and kill Azir.
Yeah, we'll see whether it is going to work out. Detonation Focus Me. The whole lot of vision around here. Matthew Crosby just showing his flair with the Teemo hat. This is how he's going to watch IWCI. Actually, on the feet. Couldn't see it too well, but man, there are so many feet in these shots.
Yeah, there certainly is. The feet coming through with a passion.
Quick shot just starting things up here.
All of a sudden, Kira roaming up trying to take out Bonzen.
Yeah, Bonzen looking to be taken down here as there's the Crescent Slash, and man, Kira doing some damage.
Yeah, and Smurf picked up the Trinity Force. All of a sudden, he's doing relevant damage as well. Trinity Force is the rush coming through here for the Ignite Hecarim. Now all four members remaining for Detonation Focus Me, they move into the mid lane and Kira's been caught.
Yeah, there's the Death Sentence coming through as well. Emperor's Divide underneath the Sun Turret. Beautifully timed as Symphony's going to flash out of the Cataclysm. Lex looking for something. Smurf with a beautiful teleport through the backside.
Diving.
But he is not very tanky at this stage. As man, that was a big ride Syros went on. Yudapon is going to fall as Kira's back in the fight. And look at the snowballing coming through from this Diana. Saros is there with a beautiful use of the Zonyas, but not that beautiful as Kira's just going to take him down for the triple.
Yeah, so what Hard Random didn't notice was the fact that they were like, hey, that's our turret. But all of a sudden, Azir puts a turret up, and that was effectively a turret dive that got them a triple kill coming up.
Yeah.
For only one member. That Diana, all of a sudden, went from being really not much of a problem to a huge problem that we have to think about as we go in. We take another look at it, actually bounced them under the turret, but to relative safety. So a little bit of a misplay coming through from Syroth. Good flank came through from Smurf, but from here it looked like it was going to go all in Detonation Focus's me favor. But Yutapon, he got deleted. All of a sudden, Kazu's by himself. They're able to get back over the wall and take out Syroth as well here. And the kill goes over to Kira as well. So to make a matter even worse, not only did they lose a fight, they lost a fight and gave all the gold to the split pusher.
Yeah.
All of a sudden, an assassin can take out Yutapon, who is the star carry coming through for Detonation Focus Me. So the Japanese team has actually been its own worst enemy. They've given the... wow.
Oh, Bonzen. Beautiful use of that Twisted Advance to get out of the way of that Crescent Strikers. Kira is going to moonfall him back in. There's the Lunar Rush. Doesn't get the reset, though. Well, actually did, as she's going to fall down.
Yeah, so they take out Bonzen again. And this is what I'm talking about. All of a sudden, the playmaker, as Demonko, a little bit caught, is super fed coming through. 8-1-0, 208 CS at only 24 minutes. They're losing turrets for it. But this is eventually going to set the CIS team up for huge success.
Well, Kira actually heading through for a flank teleport as well. Pale Cascade healing him up, and man, is he trying to get over there as Lex gets it with a beautiful use of the ricochet.
Thank you, Kira. I love that when players just show exactly what I was talking about. So Kira tried twice unsuccessfully to dive through the wall.
Yep.
Got bounced twice. So as
I was
we
doing
said,
my best to ignore it.
If it's not a blink, you can't get through.
Well, it is going to mean third dragon here for Hard Random. Detonation Focus Me forced to head back. Oh, another one! No, a little bit late this time. He'll get it next time, surely. Yutapon now knows exactly which way to go.
Yeah, he's just warming up, getting his eye in. It's only game one for Detonation Focus Me, but Hard Random, they're in a huge position to be able to take over this game now. They haven't taken any turrets apart from the bottom. And if they set Diana up in a lane, she's going to be able to really... Wow. Oh, I thought that was an enemy. Wasn't.
Well,
was
it is. It's an enemy blue buff.
It was a pink ward. Trick me. But going to be able to move the Diana into free lanes and be able to pick up a lot of farm, but more importantly, some turrets with that passive.
Yeah, precisely. He's going to be able to grab a Rift Scuttler as well, which is also very important.
Give it to you, jungler.
Only one turret down, though, for Hard Random. Detonation Focus Me have managed to take down three on this map. A bit of global gold now available for them, keeping them in this gold game, of course.
Smurf's a little bit caught.
Yeah, Devastating Charge is going to allow him to gallop gloriously away from that one. No problem at all.
Second best Hecarim skin in the game.
What, the normal one?
That's not the normal.
Isn't it? Or is that Reaper?
It's Reaper.
Ah, got it. Kira. Heading into this mid lane, is just going to try and clear out these creeps. Of course, does have to get into melee range, and it is difficult against four members of Focus Me who are hanging around. Symphony, I don't know how you managed to pick that gap. That was beautiful. Prey Seeker finding everywhere that there isn't prey somehow. Astral heading through here as well, as Lex is going to throw through a boomerang and is going to be able to pick up the farm. So a little bit of a calmed down moment.
Yeah, all they're waiting for is level 16 on their mid laner. So Kira, he's got all the gold, he's got all the kills, he's level 15, and it's a real awkward spot for every mid laner to be on level 15 because you know your power gets huge when you hit level 16. You really want the 3 points in that ultimate, and anytime you fight at level 15, you tend to lose, and then you're like, if I had a little bit of base damage yep. on that ultimate, I probably would have won. But once again, top lane getting a lot of focus, Bonzen under attack. But they've moved all their members bot. The problem, 26 minutes into the game, Baron's been started up.
Yeah, there's three members in this bottom lane. A sapling is going to spot out exactly what's going on. Bonzen is here, has teleport, but he's right next to the Baron pit. Not needed as Saros is there. But there's on the hunt pop. Saros uses that Zonya's Hourglass Empress Divide to get Demonko and Kira out of here. But Saros is just getting exploded. Cataclysm to come through. Kira's shield is gigantic as Yutapon finally manages to find his way in. But Smurf able to fear him up. Bonzen going down so incredibly low. And Hard Random all grouped up. Kira's godlike. They're going to take down the mid turret. They've already got the Baron because they had so much damage. And man, this team is looking so strong.
Yeah, it certainly is. And we talk about things that give AD carries headaches, and we put Hecarim on the top of the list. Scrap that one. 10-1-2, Diana. She takes the crown.
Oh,
there
yeah.
is no way Utapon can go anywhere near a team fight right now, because Kira, even without hitting a Q, will probably one-shot the poor dude. He's sitting on a cutlass, has next to no lifesteal, no attack speed coming through yet, has prioritized armor, doesn't even have magic resistance. He needs a Banshee's Veil yesterday if he's going to survive the damage.
And he needs about four charges on his flash and a far less cooldown on that arcane shift, because Kira is just bouncing around these fights, resetting that Lunar Rush
and
left, right,
and
center.
And now has a death cap. Wow, this Diana is all of a sudden massive. Let's take another look at it. Dumped over the wall before this and tried to get rid of Syros. They take down the Baron, good objective control over the team fight. And then look at how Smurf just attacks the backline. All of a sudden, Utapon, he's not a threat at all. He's over the wall just throwing out random Qs. And they chase through the rest of the team. They pick up the double turrets, don't go chasing kills. And the focus through from Hard Random right now is really superior to what we're seeing from Detonation Focus Me. The Japanese team seems to be out of sorts, not prioritizing the right part of the objectives. And with the 4-1 split push, 10-1 Diana, all of a sudden, that ultimate not going to be very helpful, because she'll just one-shot
My
you, Syros.
My goodness. And what with all of these Cinderhulks coming through for Hecarims as well, we're just not used to seeing this burst of damage coming through at this stage of the game with the Trinity Force Hecarim. Not to mention the fact that he now almost has the Spirit Visage and the Frozen Heart completed as well. It's just crazy seeing this coming through from Smurf as Kira continues the split push on the bottom side. Syros completely tied up trying to deal with that, as Smurf is even going to clear out the
probably
mid lane.
Probably going to go for the dive on the bottom lane. Smurf going around behind Syros. This is big trouble.
Yeah, divide this one as he takes out Kira but gets destroyed by the horse.
Yeah, so able to get in behind. All of a sudden, top lane teleport.
Yeah, speaking of getting in from behind, Astro trying to get through here as, my God, Utapon just gets eliminated there by Kira. Bonzen now in so much trouble. He's supposed to be the tank. Doesn't look tanky at this stage, as he gets destroyed by Kira as well. 12-1-4. That's the ace. Hard Random going to take down the first inhibitor of this game as well. 12,000 gold is the lead. And this CIS team, they're probably going to win off that.
Yeah, they certainly are looking to push in the base. Atlas, I was confused why they were prioritizing mid lane so high. Syros seems to be dealing with it. Now you see how Kira was able to take over the rest of the game with an advantage.
Oh, yeah.
What a composition coming through from Hard Random. They sacrifice top, they sacrifice bottom a little bit, turn them into farm lanes, but then absolutely destroyed the map through a mid lane tactic.
Yeah, it was really beautifully played, and they were timing the flashes so wonderfully as well. They made sure that they came back at the very last second of that flash cooldown to kill Syros, and that was a 3-0-0 Diana in a lane that he was getting bullied in.
Yeah, exactly right. And you know, Azir should win that lane. So throwing the attention there means that all of a sudden you can't push, you can't zone. You have to play a little bit more carefully. Azir known for being incredibly squishy. And it was just that one team fight around mid lane. They got Diana to a point that she was okay. She was still manageable. But the one with the sun turret where they pushed the team out, they actually chose to fight when Bonzen had died top lane, if you remember. So it looked like a 4v4, but really there was a fifth member that could join for Hard Random. And in the end, off the back of that, they just wiped the floor with Detonation Focus Me.
Yeah, and when you've got a Diana on, you know, what was it, 7-1 after that point, you said that things were going to go horribly wrong. I didn't quite understand the extent of which you were correct, but man, he just went completely ballistic.
And this is the thing, like, Detonation Focus Me, you saw their tactic. They were hoping to get the blue Ezreal to a point late game where just a kite monster wasn't able to be one shot and just throw out all the Qs, kite back consistently. They had a very good team comp for it. But with the pace that Diana was accelerated, outside of the fact that there was a Hecarim who's a very good anti-carry, the fact that Diana just got so huge meant that in the end, Utapon could be one shot.
Yeah, well, it was sort of one or two. But the fact that you're Diana as well means that Lunar Rush keeps getting reset by that Crescent Slash. And you just constantly get dove on over and over again. Not to mention the Moonfall coming through, Pale Cascade making you so sort of pseudo tanky at the same time. You can really get in amongst this one. And what with Wild Growth on top of it? Man, and Symphony as well. I mean, he went a little bit unspoken there, made some super aggressive plays, which in the early game may have looked over aggressive, but worked out exactly to be how Hard Random wanted it to work.
Yeah, and the thing is that Symphony was matched well early by Astaroth.
Yeah.
But then he kept up the aggressive plays, whereas Astaroth kind of retreated into the jungle. So whilst Astaroth was happy to camp bottom lane, and I think that Symphony recognized that, that's why he was going mid more often, going top more often, recognized that the camp was around bottom lane. And if he ganked there, they were going to get counter ganked. In the end, he just took the pressure elsewhere. And Yutapon, he was happy to farm, but the rest of the map just got crushed.
Yeah, and is this sort of the result of having a team that has a sort of very one-dimensional playstyle? This, okay, we're going to get behind our AD carry and play it out that way. And then Hard Random were like, okay, well, that's how you're going to play. We're going to focus the rest of the map and we're going to play this game our way because we're a little bit more flexible. Could that have been a strategy going through?
I think it was just recognized the fact that that's how they wanted to play for that particular map. I think Detonation Focus Me can mix it up a lot more than people are going to give them credit for off the back of that one performance. They definitely do concentrate around the AD carry, but their mid laner, Syros, is much better than what he showed in that match. I think that...
Well, actually, he showed a whole lot of really fantastic Azir mechanics.
He showed really good early and then just got too far behind. So I think that it was a very... Like, you don't expect for 10 kills to be on a map and 8-1-1 to be the Diana score. That's a really accelerated Diana to the point that you can't deal with it anymore.
No, and we actually saw that demonstrated. And speaking of which, let's go to a replay and see exactly how fed Kira was.
Yeah, exactly right. So this is a Baron fight where, in the end, Detonation were caught way out of position. So Focus Me is heading up the map. The CIS team Hard Random, they've already started up the Baron. And when we roll this out, you're going to see Syros take a heck of a lot of damage and have to pop Zhonya's. And this is huge, because all of a sudden, he's trapped between a rock and a hard place and can't retreat anywhere. But what really turned the fight is this moment here. Smurf dives onto the backline, and all of a sudden, Yutapon is over a wall firing Qs when really he should be in mid lane, hiding backwards with the rest of the team. He chose to go over a wall instead of going directly backwards, probably saved his life, but needed to make the higher risk play, kite back and try and deal with the Hecarim, because in the end, he just let two members of himself, his team, be collapsed on, and it was legitimately a meat grinder.
Yeah,
they just absolutely ground the rest of his team to a pulp, and then just ignored him. Ezreal's not going to do anything if it's one versus five.
He wasn't going to come
back. He wasn't going to fight anyone. He couldn't even pick up the minion wave, really. And they just tanked two turrets outright, had Baron, took the two mid turrets, and was huge.
Yeah, absolutely gigantic. I think they got about an 8,000 gold lead off that stage. It was the game-winning play that came through, and it was all about a incredibly quick call to start off the Baron. They recognized two people bottom lane and instantly went to the pit. Yeah. And that's fantastic communication straight off the bat.
Yeah, and I like that you pointed that out, because everything in this team from Hard Random pointed to the fact that they're a smart team and that they make good calls. Their mid lane camp, the Baron at the right time, the fact that they were willing to sack other parts of the map, they played that very intelligently.
Yeah, it was beautifully done. But ladies and gentlemen, there's still way more IWCI coming tonight. We are going to have a short break, but we'll be back very, very soon.